Happy New Year! Happy 2023. Thank you for being here. Welcome to January. So today we're going to do the energy forecast. And if you'd like to follow up with the healing that I offer every month in my school and in my Patreon, please check those out. If you'd like to learn Reiki and all of my work with the chakras, all of my teachings, all of my workshops, that's in my school. If you'd like to support this YouTube channel and access some exclusive videos, early access to videos, as well as a community, that's on Patreon. The links are in the description. So, today we are January the 2nd. It's the first Monday of the year. I know. I hope you had a beautiful holiday season. I hope that you celebrated with your chosen family, with your loving family, and within and outside of you. Because we also have the family that lives in our heart, the family that has been with us for many, many lives. And that's actually what we're going to start talking about. So I've been channeling the Akashic Records for a few hours now, and I've been writing and preparing so many things down concerning my personal life as well as my work and my more collective work. And it's been very incremental in how I'm going to describe what January is doing to us. So let's start channeling, and I'm going to be writing. I'm also going to be using my voice. So I know that my writing is not very legible. So what I'm going to do is that I'm going to say everything that I write with my hand so that you don't have to zoom in or crease your eyes in order to understand what's going on. But the writing helps me channel deeper. So, January 2023, which all makes up the number 7. 7 in numerology is, it's all about the sacred. It's we created the world in 7 days. We did many things. It's always 7 initiations, 7 chakras. There's a lot connected to 7. Our week is ruled by the number 7. 7 times 4 makes 28, which is the lunar cycle. And, you know, we're approximately making months around 30 and 30 days because that's how it's been created and how it makes 12 months. But if we were to follow a lunar calendar, we would have a different type of month and, you know, we would have a different type of rhythm. So 7 is going to be ruling what goes on collectively and individually. January, it's all about offering us a very beautiful insight on both ends of that spectrum. So January is a month that is called after the god Janus, and there's 2 heads, one looking that way and one looking that other way. I'll add an illustration if I can find one. So it's all about understanding the full spectrum of what's going to be going on within that year. So I highly recommend you to write things down, to actually just let your third eye connect and receive a lot of information and then write it down, because you're going to see in 2023, you're going to be referring to, or if you were to refer to, what you write down, what you witness, what you see in your dreams, in your day-to-day life, in your meditations, in those moments where you don't really control things and you're just like washing the dishes or doing some handiwork. Sometimes there's a lot of downloads that happen at those times because we're not focusing on something specific mentally, and so the body is able to receive and download a lot of things, and that's something that's going to be happening to you in January. So connecting to the crown chakra, letting it open, letting it download all the way into your third eye and receiving those information, keeping it down, writing it down, and witnessing the world as a play, because the world will be showing you what's going to be happening within and without. So within means inside of you, without means outside of you. It doesn't mean without things, it just means outside of you. So there is a big interplay between you and the outside. So let the world show you reality, show you its reality, and witness how you feel about that reality within, so that you're able to prepare for it. So January is a beautiful introduction. It's It's a summary, it's a synopsis of what's going to be happening within the month of, within all the months that make up this year. There is also a huge aspect towards connecting to the divine, connecting to, I don't want to say what you're here to do, like as in your purpose, but some people will resonate with that. There's not all of us, but a lot of us who are here, obviously to experience life, to live on this planet and to develop their own consciousness and their self-awareness and go through the journey of what your soul came here to do. So that soul incarnation, there's something here for you, but there's also something that some of you, some of us want to do for the world. So we're going back to offering that transpersonal life. And if you feel called to this, if it's a focus for you to be turned towards what you can do for others, and that's something that I relate with, right? Every time I witness something, I need to tell people. That's why I have this YouTube channel and my school. And if you feel called to this, you might feel called to my transpersonal chakras work. And that has been a series of workshops, of retreats, and they're all in my school, but they're also that's also something that I'm doing right now, as in I'm writing a book about it. And I'm developing more that work that started in 2020 for me and that I've been offering people. So if you're called to this, you could join my Patreon, because I'm sharing a lot about the project of writing that book. But also you can join my school, because that's going to be helpful for you to go through the different initiations, the seven initiations, the seven chakras, for you to go through those openings, those activating of those specific body activations, those different points in the body that make up your transpersonal chakra system. So it's upon the understanding that we have more than seven chakras, you know, from the crown to the root. There's actually in between and above and beyond and below, there's other points, other chakras. And when you activate them, you get in contact with your past lives, you get in contact with your higher self, with your different parts of yourself that have been on this planet or will be on this planet. And there's also a deeper realization of your incarnation, of your soul incarnation on this earth, so you can do more while you are in the physical. And that's life-giving, that's life-affirming to understand, for those of us who are called to this work, to be able to tap into those points and receive so much knowledge and information. And obviously some of it is veiled and it's confusing sometimes because we're not yet ready. But what I'm doing with those workshops and what I'll be doing with this book is really just make it super clear, super transparent for you to understand. I'm not saying this to sell something. I'm just making you aware of the reality of this work, because I know that it's going to be so helpful, and it's a theme. It's like a theme of 2023, to open more to your mission on Earth. And coincidentally, I decided to share all of this work along a photo of me and Joan of Arc. So Joan of Arc is a French saint that you might know of. She's quite famous internationally. She heard voices from God who told her what to do in order to be of service to her country. And so while France was in a war with England, she was just a young woman who received a lot of voices and a lot of guidance, and all the way until she was from 14 to 17 years old, she did a lot to free France from the attacks of the English. And she was burned at the stake when she was 17, but in between those years she was embodying and incarnating her highest self, as well as the mission for God that she was doing. Not to say that, you know, God was with France and not with the English, not at all. But what was needed was peace, and that's what happened with her work and within history as it's written. You know, after her, a new king was installed and a lot of things happened so that England and France were not at war again. And that was God's work, to install a peace that had been disturbed for more than 100 years. And actually more than that. It's called the 100 Years War, but it was more than 100, and I'm not going to enter that. But anyway, she heard something, she did it, she followed her truth. She followed the truth that was guided to her, and some things happened. So you might feel called to such things if you connect to that crown, to that third eye, and you start envisioning things that you could be doing for the world. And so that inner you and that outside reality will merge in a new way. There's going to be new bridges and a new influence, a new impact that you could be having. So whether it's, you know, posting a few things on social media, or writing something, or creating something, or involving yourself in your community in a different way. It doesn't mean to mean the whole world, right? The outside world could be your local community, it could be your city, it could be your country, it could be anything. It could be your family even. It could be like saying some things that your family hasn't said in years, and delving into deeper themes, deeper objects that are outside of you and that will benefit others, that will catalyze the awakening of others, which is not always easy. There's a deep understanding of the word sacrifice, which is to make sacred. It doesn't mean to give away yourself, but it does imply that you're giving away of your energy, of your time, of your focus. So it's the you giving to others. I'm really not using this paper the way I was thinking I would, but anyway, I hope that this is clear. So if this doesn't resonate, if you do not choose, because you have the choice always, if you do not choose or do not want to be involved in all of that, in giving to others, which is totally fine and absolutely not judged, it's a calling or it's not a calling, you know, then it will be a focus about your incarnation, about what you're here to do in your life for yourself, for your opening, for your liberation. So maybe you've been entrenched into different concepts, and you're going to see those concepts unlock themselves, and you're going to witness new things that are here for your freedom, for your inner peace, for your equilibrium, for your own harmony, which is super good. So this year, it's going to be a lot of lessons. And this month, it's going to be a lot of insights into the whole year. Mercury is retrograde, which means what we know it means, but it also means a new way of receiving communication, a new way of receiving insights, a new way of just understanding language, just receiving new languages. So maybe you could be witnessing light language coming through for you, or channeling the Akashic Records, or using the tarot, or many other things. So thank you for watching, and happy 2023. And now, if you want to witness the healing and more development into what we talked about here, I highly encourage you to join me on my Patreon or my school, because we're going to offer some energy healing to unblock a lot of things and give you directly a piece of insight. Thank you for watching. See you.